Hello YouTube, this is a tutorial on how to install Feed the Beast and the DireWolf20 mod pack for Syndrome's server. Everything may look a little different. I'm using a template from my Twitch stream. Also, the quality is a little bit better than my Twitch stream since I don't have to be uploading anything, streaming anything, then I can choose whatever quality I want. So, HD, yay! Anyway, let's get down to business. So, the first thing you're going to do is you're going to go down to the Feed the Beast, or you're going to go to Google and you're going to search Feed the Beast. Bam, first link. Take you to this website. All you have to do is scroll down just a bit. You'll find client download. You're going to click on the download exe. You're going to save the file. Depending on what browser you have, this may be different, but for Firefox users, this is pretty much what you get. So you can go ahead and save it onto the desktop, is where it should be, unless you want to be navigating through folders to find the launcher. This is the launcher and not the installer, so you will be installing mod packs from this launcher, and you will be using it to play the game. So make sure you save it in a convenient place. I've already downloaded it, so yay. Anyway, once it's downloaded, you'll have your Feed the Beast launcher. I have mine up in the corner over there. You're gonna click on it, you're gonna run it. There is one thing I forgot to do. Let me do that real quick. I forgot to reset my Feed the Beast. There we go. Now we got a clean, fresh start, and I can teach you what to do. Okay, so I'm just gonna go ahead and delete this real quick. Anyway, here we are. Everything is as you see it when you first launch the launcher. You may or may not get this console. If you do, you can leave it up, or you can close it. It will not make any difference whatsoever. So here you have your launcher, you have your mod packs, you have options, texture packs you can download, but you want to be on mod packs here. The first step we're going to do is we're going to go and click on Select Profile, and then you're going to click on Create Profile. Here you're going to type in your Mojang or Minecraft username and password. Doesn't need to be an email. In fact, if you use the email, it won't work. It has to be your Minecraft username. So that's step one. Step two is to go down here and where it says recommended and click on 1.0.6. Syndrome server is currently running on 1.0.6. And if you choose recommended or any other version for that matter, you won't be able to log in. So, once you have that, you're going to go ahead and click launch. It will start to download over here. This may take a little while. I'm going to leave this video unedited so you can see that. See everything that pops up, and so that in case you think that something's going wrong, you can just watch this and see if yours is doing the same thing as mine does. Let's hope yours does the same thing mine does. So enjoy the music while this downloads, and I'll be here once it's done.
Look at yourself and realize life's been treating you nice. You better be wise and enjoy your moment. Take one look at yourself through your eyes. How you treated your life, it wasn't wise. Cause it's getting closer.
At the Alamo Colleges, it's not just about starting your higher education. We want you to complete it. Our colleges do that. Whether your interest is in the health and
sorry about the ad.
Advanced manufacturing, maybe
not
science,
my fault.
Technology, or the arts. At the Alamo Colleges, we're doing more than just teaching these courses. We're creating leaders in these fields and in our communities. We are reshaping futures and building
okay,
leaders.
So the download is finished. The Alamo Colleges. And this is the part that confuses and frustrates a lot of people, making them rage and say that the Feed the Beast launcher is not working and not responding. So here, you can't click on anything. It looks like the launcher just says completely frozen. Well, you can change the packs, but it may appear that the launcher is frozen and has crashed. It has not crashed, I assure you that. It's connecting to a server or something and it's downloading some music files. I don't know why they're downloading music files, but you will see a pop-up. See? There it is. There's this pop-up, and this happens two or three times. And it's downloading some OGG files, which are, they're music files. So yeah, that'll happen a few times. It does take quite a while. I guess depending on how fast your internet is, it'll download those files. So, yeah. Here's another one. And another one. Alright, the launcher has now disappeared. Don't panic, it will bring up the Minecraft game in just a second. Oh, look, here it is. And it may appear also that the Minecraft game is not responding. It is quite a big game now. It has 129 mods, which is a lot to load compared to the vanilla Minecraft. So, just wait. Be patient. Patience is a virtue. And the game will soon be ready. Don't panic, I meant to do that, just to make sure that it's still here. Aha, here we go. So the game is up now.
I'm going to change a few things so everything looks a little bit better. Here we go. So here we are. We have Minecraft up and running. I don't know if you can see this, it might be blocked by the template, but there's 129 mods. Forge mod loader is 6.4.45.953. The Minecraft version is 1.6.4. So anyway, you'll go to the server, add server. This is Syndromes. Syndrome of Pan's DireWolf20 server. The IP address is 50. Crud, I got rid of the IP. Give me a moment, folks. I don't have it by memory yet. Help me, Nightbot. Come on, wake up, Nightbot. Thank you, Nightbot. It is 50.31.113.66. Don't need to worry about a port, it's the default port. So here we are, we have his server. Click connect. And here we are, we're now in the game. And that should be it. Of course you won't spawn in this village, this is where my base is. I don't think you can see my coordinates anywhere, so Anyway, have fun on the server. I hope this helped you. And I will see y'all later.